First, the reason I brought Mini-Me back up here, you remember I said yesterday, when assets digitize, things change fast. We all know how long it takes to develop a new drug or treatment. But I went back last night, and on Facebook, my friends were talking about the FDA has just approved 3D-printed facial bones. So people either with damage from an accident or a genetic defect now will be able to have implants printed. So many of the discussions, the things that people said in the last few minutes were excellent. Who was it who said we need e-doctors and e-nurses? Mm. One of the things I didn't get to in my talk yesterday is we have a society for participatory medicine now, which is about the doctor-patient partnerships. Several of you have talked to me in the halls, and Rodrigo, I hear it in your... we were in a taxi last night, and I heard his sleep apnea story. One of my aphorisms is patient is not a third-person word. If this hasn't hit your family yet, and several of you have talked about this, right, when it's your mother, your child, or somebody, or you, whose life is threatened, all of this looks different now. It becomes not just a business opportunity. Now, in 2009, 2 years after my disease, I got approached on Twitter by a woman named Regina Holiday, who would be a fabulous person to bring here next year. Her husband was dying of kidney cancer, the same disease I had, but they had been to 3 bad hospitals in a row in Washington, D.C., and a customer of hers ran into her at the toy shop where she works and said, "Oh my God, kidney cancer, you need to meet e-patient Dave." The next night, she was talking to me on the phone, having spent more than a year of bad results in the medical system. And the day after that, she was talking to my oncologist. So having spent all this time looking for what she needed through traditional channels, she ended up finding it through Twitter on her first day as a Twitter user. After her husband died, because for him it was too late, she realized that, and this was a poor woman living in a poor part of Washington, D.C., and of course, you know, you talk about it costs the health system how much to have another sleep apnea device made. Well, in America, you just go bankrupt paying for it yourself, right? And this was a real problem for her. She realized so many people are going around with medical stories, and nobody can see them. It's like this. Mm-hmm. And so she started painting people's stories on the back of a jacket.
We need a close-up on this one. Camera. Okay.
And what she has now created...
You have to stand still okay. So they can see.
This is the phone call where she met me. Her son was 3 years old. His world was falling apart, was clinging to his mother's legs. She'd heard this e-patient. She was cooking macaroni. She thought the phone cord and the macaroni looked like the letter E. And this is where she found what she would have needed. She now has more than 300 of these jackets that she's created for people. There are people in the American government, people in other countries, because we are all walking around with stories, and all of this refocuses, like turning the lens on an SLR camera when you look at it from the perspective of the patient. So that's why I wore this today.